This channel and its content are intended for adults 18 and older. This video was filmed for educational and documentary purposes only. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content and mash the thumbs up button.
What's up, homies?
This is your boy BWS Rose coming at you with a video again. Going to give a quick review on this light right here. This is the Mars Hydro 902. It is a pretty inexpensive, good light. I mean, it is a really good light. It is not a quantum board. It is a, I guess what you would call a blurple configuration. I've had this for about a year. I've done a couple of grows with it, and it did perform magnificently, actually. This is probably the high end of their old technology, because Mars Hydro has also moved on to make a white light quantum board to kind of reflect the industry standard. So this light is not going to be as efficient as an HLG 550 or the likes of that. But they do now make some options from Mars Hydro that are a little bit more affordable, probably, than an HLG or some other companies that are still going to have a white light spectrum. So I used this to grow the last grow that I did with the two autoflowers. And in the middle of the grow, I noticed that a portion of the light was not working. It was not lit up. Now, I don't know if I'm pointing out the exact section, but it was a spot about that big, about a strip like that. So, not only is this going to be a review on the quality of this light and what it can do, but this is also a review on Mars Hydro's customer service and my experience with them. So it was in the middle of the grow. I didn't want to stop. I didn't have any other options at that time. This was the only light that I possessed. And so I just pushed forward and I got to harvest. Everything seemed to work out good. Although I will say that I think the harvest could have been a whole lot better if I would have had the light working at a full capacity. So, long story short, guys, I contacted Mars Hydro by email. They had me take some photographs of the light, both on and off, and email it back to them so they could show the images to an engineer. And after a couple of correspondence, they determined that there were a couple of things that could possibly be wrong with the light. One of those things would be that the diodes were burned out. The other thing would have been that the power drivers could have been not working properly. So they sent me some instruction eventually that led me to disassemble this light. And after disassembling it, I did realize that it was one of the power drivers that was malfunctioning. So Mars Hydro did send me a new driver, and I am going to be disassembling this light again and reinstalling the new driver. So guys, in this package is the new driver that Mars Hydro sent me. It is cheap. It is not a quality driver. It is completely encased in plastic. I think it is 100 volts. There are five other drivers inside this light that match it. And I would imagine it is components like this that make this light a little more affordable than some of the others. I do want to talk a little bit about the packaging. The package that this was sent in, guys, is a bubble-wrapped envelope. But the bubble wrap is not very thick, and I was a little shocked that an electronic device like this wasn't sent in a better package. You can see there that it's was sent first class mail. It was very discreet. I mean, it's just an electrical driver, so the discreetness I don't think matters, but the protection of it was a little shoddy. I will say that for this video. But guys, I'm going to play a slideshow now of some previous plants that I grew with this light and give a little description, so I hope you enjoy that. Overall, I will say that the customer service aspect with Mars Hydro was absolutely excellent. All of their emails came less than 24 hours in most cases. And when I say all of their emails, really, we only went back and forth with each other three or four times. And each correspondent was very prompt. So guys, as you can see from these photos, this Mars Hydro 900 had no problem developing a beautiful canopy of plants. The plants responded well to the light. It does have a veg and a bloom switch, but as you can see in these photos, it was able to produce some big, fat, sticky nugs. No problems at all. Lots of heads. Everything developed just fine. For a first-time grower who wants an inexpensive light that's going to produce for them, this is absolutely a recommendation for the Mars products. Their customer service was on point. I can't say enough about that, but the product itself actually works. The biggest downfall that I have with this style of light, meaning the blurple coloration, is it is very difficult to diagnose your plants if they are having some sort of deficiency or nutrient burn. Because the color is purple, it's just not apparent right away. You got to get those girls in some regular light, you know, every once in a while, so you can really take a good look at what's going on with the surface of your leaves. Other than that, again, this light performed outstanding. And again, as you can see, those are some big, knotty nug. I mean, some of them were as big as, you know, a bottle of water. Very satisfied with the outcome. I highly recommend. So guys, I am now going to disassemble this light and put the new driver, take the old driver out, put the new driver in. It's just a matter of taking apart like maybe 8 screws, maybe 10 screws total, and doing a little bit of unplugging of the components on the inside. There wasn't any soldering required for this repair, and it was just very, very simple. I've never had an electronics company actually request that I take their product apart. Usually that, you know, void your manufacturer's warranty. But I think that since this company is based in China, you know, to save on shipping costs and time, they attempt to diagnose it through photographs and then give you their best opinion and then guide you step by step. They didn't leave me hanging at all on how to repair the device yourself. So guys, I'm going to speed this video up a little bit. And put on a little bit of music, so enjoy that, and you'll see how this all comes together, and I get the light repaired. I have gotten in here previous, so all of this stuff is already disconnected. This is the guts of the light, and as you can see, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 separate drivers. And these 6 separate drivers run these 4 fans, the coolant, and the LED board itself. Now, what we've got over here is the actual heatsink that's aluminum. It's pretty thin.
And so, not that it doesn't dissipate heat, but it's a thin piece of metal, so it's not going to dissipate it as well. Hence why we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 fans here, okay? So, as you can see, on this side are the actual diodes. This is the actual LED board. All of this, by the way, detaches. So, from the backside, if I wanted to, I could take this out. But the efficiency of this unit is not going to be as great as if it was powered with one large driver. So, like I said, I've already opened this unit up. I happen to know which one of these drivers is not good, and so it happens to be driver F. So that's the one I'm going to go for, and that's the one I am going to be removing. So we'll try to get this all lined up. Suffering made me realize what it takes, and that I'll to be an attitude.
So guys, to finalize, I just want to say that I do think that the Mars Hydro products are a top quality product. Are they the best light in the market? Absolutely not. But for the money, for somebody who's just starting out on a grow, they perform tremendously well. And the customer service, which I've just recently found out, is top notch. So guys, smash that thumbs up button, like and subscribe. I'll put a link to the light down at the bottom, and I'll catch you next time. Peace out, brothers.